is the BMS board. There has been no alterations done with this board, and it came from a dead battery pack. The cells had gone dead. In fact, that was these cells here. The cells were unable to be reclaimed, completely dead. However, the board was good, and we hooked up an XD60 and balancing leads to it. Now we are able to hook this up to any 6S LiPo battery. When we do so, an error appears in the goggles to the right-hand corner, telling us that we have battery inconsistent firmware. Do you want to upgrade? Always press cancel. Once you have pressed cancel, everything is able to power on. Your FPV drone will be able to fly, and you are able to progress upon your journey as per normal. As for the readouts or the status of the battery, I, in my test, have found that the readouts in the percentage given in the goggles is accurate and thus can be trusted. Here is our custom case that we have made to replicate the original case we have here. This is one that has been removed and taken apart. This is 3D printed and is very easy to install. Put it in like this. Put your stopper right here. There we go. And that keeps the case from coming out. So it's nice and secure in here, just like so. Here is my board. The top has been removed as such. It has been cut off from the original. We put that aside. This allows us to use the buttons as normal. Here is our SMS 1400 milliamp battery. We have, this is the battery that's most compatible with the space confines we have. And the results of this in testing, it does add a minute or two onto it. This is a stock FPV drone. It has carbon blades on it, but they perform just as the normal stock ones. So this has not been hacked. The software, this is all stock. And it was able to do, instead of 8 minutes on a normal stock battery, it has now allowed us to do 8 minutes. Same with this modified configuration. This upgraded one has 5.1 props on it. Greater performance, but less battery time on the stock batteries, usually 5 minutes, but this allows it to do 6 to 7 minutes. So regardless of your FPV configuration, it does add a minute or two of flight time onto your operation. Okay, with our case in here, this battery will slip in as such. Slips right in here. Perfect. It even has a little room up here. And then this plugs right into it. One puts this out of the way, one puts this on top, then plugs right in here, just like so. And there we have it. We will use a zip tie here. It goes around the front. It does not interfere with the camera operations or movement whatsoever. Comes around the back and then zip ties this nice and snug. Here the wires come out in the allotted space provided, and it does so very well. Push just like this, and it's all nice and flush along there. No stress on this, so it remains plugged in, and it's very little pressure at all required. We can do a 3D printed type thing, but I do like the original setup with being able to push the buttons and have normal stock operations. And then these cables plug together, and you're off to the races. as we have demonstrated, it will start up. The only error that you will see in the goggles is firmware inconsistency. You press cancel and then you take off. So now what we have demonstrated here is the ability to use any 6S battery, well, this particular 6S battery, 1400 milliamp battery, will slip in here with no problems, and you just take it out and you charge it like any LiPo battery. No modifications required on the battery itself. This is the biggest one we could fit in here. A 1600 milliamp battery is too wide for this, but a 1400 milliamp battery works, and there are no disadvantages for what I can see. As you use the battery, the proper percentage is displayed in the goggles, and I have tested this on several flights, and to confirm that it does indeed reflect the proper percentage based on the usage of the battery. So it displays properly in the goggles and adds a minute or two, depending on how you fly, your particular variation of the FPV drone. So you do get increased flight time with this battery. These are available. I will put the link below on where you can get them. And this, as well as I do possess the STO file for this configuration. All right, let us now compare the weight. The original battery is 288 grams. Our present setup, allowing you to have 1 to 2 more minutes onto your flight time, you have 293 grams right here. So it weighs even less than the original battery, and you get more extended flight time.